Hello students, welcome to our class. In our previous lecture we have talked about the type of the protective tissue, epidermis. Okay, under this section we are going to talk about another protective tissue, that is cork. Now when we had a talk about the epidermis, there we have mentioned a term, young plant, or the plant which is not having any woody part in it. Okay, there is no woody growth, there is no secondary growth. At that time the plant part from the tip of its shoot till the tip of its root was covered by a thin single layer covering, that is epidermis. Okay, so now in the, when we are going to talk about cork, there we are going to talk about the mature plant, a tree. So in that case the epidermis is replaced by other kind of a tissue, that is lateral meristem. Okay, that lateral meristem tissue will keep on dividing and form layers of the cells. Those layers of the cells, they become dead and form another kind of a protective layer in the case of the woody plant, or we can say at the time of the secondary growth, that is called cork. So what the cork is? Cork protective tissue. Okay, which present at the time of secondary growth in a plant. Okay, fine. It is multi-layer. When we are going to talk about the cork, cork is multi-layered dead tissue. Other than that, no intercellular space, or we can say highly compact. Okay, there is, the tissue is tightly packed and there is a deposition of a chemical. That chemical is suberin, which is present in the cell wall of cork cells. Okay, we are going to talk everything in detail. It's just about a kind of a protective tissue which replaces the epidermis in the case of the woody plants, or we can call it the trees, at the time of the maturity. So that epidermis is replaced by a protective tissue which we are going to call as a cork. Fine. So this is mainly present at the stem part, that is the trunk of the tree, and the roots at the time of the secondary growth. Fine. That is cork. Now, how cork is formed? We just take a very brief about this because this is not a part of the syllabus, but we are going to talk very little about this. So, as the tissue keep on going to as the plant is going to become woody, reaches to the secondary growth, what is going to happen? There is a particular layer of the meristematic cells. Okay, these are the meristematic cells. This is which type of meristematic? Lateral meristem. Okay, and this lateral meristem is going to form is cambium. Okay, lateral meristem bhi phir further do types ka ho jata hai. So there is one cambium. This cambium is going to divide in this way. Okay, it will divide outside also, it will divide inner side also. It means the layer of the cells are added on outer side also and inner side also. Here we have to talk about the cork, so we'll talk about the external, jo bahar ki side cells form ho rahi hai. Okay, in this way the layer of the cells will keep on forming. Got it? And epidermis is here, epidermis is present outside. This is the outermost covering. So as these layers are keep on dividing, so what is going to happen? Divide, divide, form layers, and as they become multi-layered, well, this was the one of the characteristic. So there is a deposition start, that deposition of suberin. The cell wall gets suberized, that is the suberin deposition is there in the cell wall, which make them dead, inactive. Okay, the cells become inactive, they become dead. Now this complete part where it is compactly arranged and it form, when it was at the division stage, jab ye cell divide kar lump puri aise layers bana rahi thi. Now these internal, jo inner layers bani hain, they are going to put down the pressure, they are going to create a pressure, and these epidermal cells are going to get rupture. Okay, this complete part is going to get rupture. Now the externally which is present, this is the cork, this complete is the cork tissue. Okay, because the epidermis was young, immature, and these cells was hard, they are dead. So as they are present, as the, because over here the division is continued and these cells are dead. So this is just like a compressive, when we are going to placed in a closed container, then what is going to happen? We are going to put a kind of a pressure on the walls. ठीक है, हम दोनों साइड से अपना पूरा प्रेशर लगाएंगे जितना भी हम लगा सकते हैं. तो सेम वे ये सारी जो सेल्स हैं, द लेयर दीज आर गोइंग टू पुट प्रेशर ऑन आउटसाइड ओवर द एपिडर्मिस. ठीक है, एंड दैट एपिडर्मिस गेट रप्चर्ड. नाउ द प्लेस ऑफ द एपिडर्मिस इज टेकन बाय दिस न्यू टिश्यू इन अ वुडी प्लांट दैट इज ड्यूरिंग द सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ दैट इज एक्टिंग एज अ प्रोटेक्टिव टिश्यू ओवर हियर. Fine. Now this cork, which is containing the deposition of the suberin, this suberin is impervious to water, okay. So as it is impervious to water, it will not allow the water to move in. Fine. And not going to allow the damage of the inner part, inner cells of the plant, which are not in the direct contact, they will not easily get spoiled in anyhow, in any manner. They are not going to spoil. There will be no mechanical injury to the inner living cells because of the cork tissue. So in that way it will help. And as it is dead, so what it is going to do, it will provide mechanical strength to the plant part where it is present. Now other than this, the cork is commercially used. Commercially used means it is having a use in a market, in different household products it is used. Fine. So if I'm going to talk about the cork, as it is lighter in weight, okay, present inner to the bark part, because outermost use bark ke saath hi associated hota hai ye tissue, this is the cork, and it is a very good shock absorber. So it is used for various purposes. It is used to make that bottle stoppers, ठीक है, इट इज यूज टू मेक रैकेट्स ऑफ टेनिस, द टेबल टेनिस विच वी यूज टू प्ले, इट यूज टू मेक द शटल दैट वी यूज टू प्ले, बैडमिंटन शटल दैट इज प्लेड, फ्लोरिंग इज ऑल्सो डन, फ्लोरिंग इज ऑल्सो डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस कॉर्क मटीरियल. ओके, सो and in the packing of some items which can be damaged during the transportation, that can also be packed with the help of this cork. So this overall act as a shock absorber. Fine, as it is lighter in weight also. So the main is, this tissue is a protective in nature, it is multi-layer, present as a outer covering in the case of the woody plants. Okay, so along with the protection, it provide mechanical strength to the plant. Fine. Thank you.